I can't thank you guys for the opportunity. Let me tell you something. If tomorrow wasn't promised, what would you give for today? Forget everything else. Forget everything else. Forget that there was any sunlight left. What would you spend today thinking about? Yourself? Or the man that's beside you? Or the man that you know you'll give everything in your heart for? We get one opportunity in life. One chance in life to do whatever you're gonna do, to lay your foundation, to make whatever mark you're gonna make, whatever legacy you're gonna leave, leave your legacy. And it's found through effort. Wins and losses come a dime a dozen. But effort, nobody can judge effort. Because effort is between you and you. Effort ain't got nothing to do with nobody else. So that team that think they ready to see you, they think what they seen on film, they ain't saw what film shows. Because every day is a new day. Every moment is a new moment. So now you got to go out and show them that I'm a different creature now than I was 5 minutes ago. Because I'm pissed off for greatness. Because if you ain't pissed off for greatness, that means you okay with being mediocre. And ain't no man in here okay with being just basic. So let's do what we do. Tonight. Think about the fight. Think about the fight. Clubber Lankin, he's trying to hurt you, Rock. He's trying to hurt you. Okay, here it comes. Jab. He's jabbing. He's jabbing. He's trying to hurt you. You gotta fight him. You gotta move.
If he wasn't here, I probably wouldn't be alive today. The fact that you're here and doing as well as you're doing gives me, what do you call it, a motivation, huh? To stay alive? Because I think that people die sometimes when they don't want to live no more.
Nature's smarter than people think.
And nature is smarter than people think. Little by little, we lose our friends, we lose everything, we keep losing and losing till we say, you know, what the hell am I living around here for? I got no reason to go on. But with you, kid, boy, I got a reason to go on. And I'm gonna stay alive. And I will watch you make good.
And I'll never leave you.
And I'll never leave you until that happens. Because when I leave you, you'll not only know how to fight, you'll be able to take care of yourself outside the ring too. Is that okay?
It's okay.
I got a little gift for you. Oh, no, wait a minute. Look at this. See that? This is the favorite thing that I have on this earth. And Rocky Marciano gave me that. You know what it was? His cufflink. Huh? And now I'm giving it to you. it's got to be like an angel on your shoulder, see? And if you ever get hurt and you feel that you're going down, this little angel is going to whisper in your ear. He's going to say, get up, you son of a bitch!
Trees, I done something new for this fight. I done wrestled with an alligator. That's right, I have wrestled with an alligator. I done tussled with a whale. I done handcuffed lightning, throw thunder in jail. That's bad. Only last week, I murdered a rock, injured a stone, hospitalized a brick. I'm so mean, I make medicine sick.
Bad dude.
Bad. Fast. Last night, I cut the light off in my bedroom, hit the switch, was in the bed before the room was dark. Picked, but the man's in trouble. I'm gonna show you how great I am.
Got him hurt bad.
Yeah.
Now he's worried. You cut him. You hurt him. You see? You see? He's not a machine. He's a man.
You know, when you get old in life, things get taken from you. I mean, that's part of life. But you only learn that when you start losing stuff. You find out life's this game of inches. So is football. Because in either game, life or football, the margin for error is so small. I mean, one half a step too late or too early, you don't quite make it. One half second too slow, too fast, you don't quite catch it. The inches we need are everywhere around us. They're in every break of the game, every minute, every second. On this team, we fight for that inch. On this team, we tear ourselves and everyone else around us to pieces for that inch. We claw with our fingernails that inch. Because we know when we add up all those inches, that's gonna make the fucking difference between winning and losing. Between living and dying. I'll tell you this, in any fight, it's the guy who's willing to die who's gonna win that inch. And I know if I'm gonna have any life in it, it's because I'm still willing to fight and die for that inch. Because that's what living is. The 6 inches in front of your face. Now I can't make you do it. You gotta look at the guy next to you. Look into his eyes. Now I think you're gonna see a guy who will go that inch with you. You're gonna see a guy who will sacrifice himself for this team because he knows when it comes down to it, you're gonna do the same for him. That's the team, gentlemen. And either we heal now as a team, or we will die as individuals.
That's football, guys. That's all it is. Now, what are you gonna do?
Special, I made my mind up to be special. Greatness is a lot of small things done well, stacked on top of each other. Schoolwork, yes ma'am, no ma'am, pants pulled up over my waist. Small things that makes greatness. So when somebody finally sees you, they represent you as a king because you walk as a king.
It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you gotta be willing to take the hits and not pointing fingers saying you ain't where you wanna be because of him or her or anybody. Cowards do that and that ain't you. You're better than that.
There's not a person on my team in 16 years that has consistently beat me to the ball every play. That ain't got nothing to do with talent. That's just got everything to do with effort. Nothing else. 15 straight years, 12 Pro Bowls later, if you want numbers, I done saw all of it. And the only thing that's kept me around is my effort. So when you put on this, all I ever knew, because I wasn't a number one recruit, I wasn't a number one linebacker, I wasn't even an immediate guy. All I ever knew was effort will get me seen on tape. Effort will get me noticed to get to the league. Effort will one day take care of my mom and my kids. Effort. Between you and me, nobody else can give you effort. Effort is with inside. And I'm still grinding because the next kid is talking about he getting too old. Keep watching me if I am. Nobody ain't got to convince me of what I do. I do what I do because I do what I do because I'm built from something. And man didn't create it. Every one of you men here have that opportunity, man. But ask yourself the question personally. How much time you really wasting? For real.
Most of you won't be successful because when you study it and you get tired, you quit. I'm here to tell you today, if you got it, somebody came to my office the other day crying. I said, look, don't cry to give up. Cry to keep going. Don't cry to quit. You already in pain. You already hurt. Get a reward from it. Don't go to sleep until you succeed.
Shut me up. And you shut me up, then that's what it is. Until then, I'm the king. Dedication. Hard work. Dedication. Hard work. I'm a one-man army. One-man army. The world can go against me. I'm still coming on top. I got God on my side.
I
He said, when you were underwater, what did you want to do? Lee, I'm looking for a different word though than live. What's that word? He said, I wanted to breathe. He told the guy, he said, when you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful. I don't know how many of y'all got asthma in here today, but if you ever had an asthma attack before, you short of breath, SOB, shortness of breath, you wheezing. The only thing you trying to do is get some air. You don't care about no basketball game. You don't care what's on TV. You don't care about nobody calling you. You don't care about a party. The only thing you care about when you're trying to breathe is to get some fresh air. That's it. And when you get to the point where all you want to do is be successful, as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful. I'm here to tell you, number one, that most of you say you want to be successful, but you don't want it bad. You just kind of want it. You don't want it badder than you want to party. You don't want it as much as you want to be cool. Most of you don't want success as much as you want to sleep. Some of you love sleep more than you love success. And I'm here to tell you today, if you're going to be successful, you got to be willing to give up sleep.
I'm the best ever. I'm the most brutal and vicious and most ruthless champion there's ever been. There's no one can stop me. Lynx is a conqueror. No, I'm Alexander. He's no Alexander. I'm the best ever. There's never been anybody as ruthless. I'm Sonny Liston. I'm Jack Dempsey. There's no one like me. I'm from Nairclaw. There's no one that can match me. My style is impetuous. My defense is impregnable. And I'm just ferocious. I want your heart.
Somebody telling you what you can and cannot do. Some of us, we were born to fly. But what I'm telling you is when you become the right person, what I mean by the right person is once you identify who you are and you begin to separate yourself from the masses and you begin to see your individuality, and you begin to see your talents, and you begin to see your personal skills. All right, it's like this. If you ever wore a suit from the store before, that's one thing. But if you ever got a suit tailored, are you hearing what I'm saying? If you ever got a tailored suit before, you know that it's different from going to buy a one-size-fits-all suit and then having a suit that's tailor-made. It fit different. The pants are different. The way you walk in it is totally different. Why? Because it's fit to you. And what I'm telling you is you need to have a tailor-made life. When you were created, you were created with a specific purpose, a specific design. I don't care if you was born and, you know, your parents didn't claim you. You still special. I don't care if your mama went in your life, your daddy went in your life. You are still special. When you were created, you were designed to do what nobody else can do. And I'm telling you, when you become the right person, when you become the right person, what you do is you start separating yourself from other people. You begin to have a certain uniqueness. As long as you're following other people, as long as you're being a copycat, you will never ever be the best copycat in the world, but you will be the best you could be. So I'm challenging you, number one, I'm challenging you to define your value, right?
Number two, I challenge you, listen to me. If you want to make more money, if you want to be more successful, if you want to have and do stuff you ain't never done before, number two, I'm asking you to invest in you. That's right, invest what? Number one, I'm asking you to invest time. I'm asking you to invest time in yourself. Some of y'all, you spend so much time with other people. You spend so much time trying to get people to like you. You spend so much time trying to fit in that you don't even know who you are. You know other people more than you know yourself. You studied them. You know about them. You want to hang out like them. You want to be just like them. And you know what? You've invested so much time in them, you don't know who you are. I challenge you to spend time by yourself. I challenge you to take yourself out. There's some young ladies right now, you fine, you pretty, you got it going on. Some brothers, you handsome, you suave, you got swag. But you know what your problem is? You've been in one relationship after another relationship, and you ain't never been in a good relationship because you don't even know you. You spend so much time taking her out. You spend so much time trying to impress him. You spend so much time buying her flowers, taking her out to lunch. You spend so much time calling him. You don't even know who you are. You heard what I said. You've invested so much of your time in being liked by other people, being loved by other people, being appreciated by other people, that you don't even know who you are. And I challenge you to invest time in your own self. I challenge you to get to a place when people don't like you, it don't even bother you no more. Why? Because you're not concerned with trying to make them happy, because you're trying to blow up. You're trying to get to the next level. E.T., I don't like the fact that you do this. I don't care. I'm not living my life for you. I'm living my life for me.
But if I can change one life today, just by telling you to be different, do something different, and take God with you, I don't care where you go, then do it. Then do it. And when you do it, let your name be worth more than your bank account. When you're finally ready to go home, make sure your footsteps are remembered.
Greatness is not this wonderful, esoteric, elusive, godlike feature that only the special among us will ever taste. You know, it's something that truly exists in all of us. It's very simple. This is what I believe, and I'm willing to die for it. Yeah. Period. It's that simple. The first step before anybody else in the world believes it is you have to believe it. There's no reason to have a plan B because it distracts from plan A. There's a redemptive power that making a choice has, you know, rather than feeling like you're at effect to all the things that are happening. Make a choice. Like, you just decide what it's going to be, who you're going to be, how you're going to do it. Just decide. And then from that point, the universe is going to get out your way.
My mind and my body will fall.
Who am I? I am a champion.
I will acknowledge the fact that my opponents do not expect me to win, but I will never surrender. Weakness will not be in my heart. I will look to my comrades and to those who have brought me to this world and those who have trained me, and I will draw strength from them.
Who am I? I am a champion.
I will gradually go out into the field of battle, and I will move in everything I can do, and I will reach my field of battle at any means at my disposal. And when I get there, I will ride violently. I will rip the heart from my enemy and leave it bleeding on the ground, because he cannot stop me.
Who am I? I am a champion.
To my side, I have comrades. Comrades that have been through me through thick and thin, through sacrifice, through blood, through sweat, through tears. Never will I let them fall. Never will I let them down. And I will never leave an enemy behind, because our opponent does not know my heart.
Who am I? I am a champion.
No one will deny me. No one will define me. And no one will tell me who and what I am and can be. Belief will change my world. It has moved continents, it has moved countries, it has put man on the moon. And it will carry me through this battle.
Who am I?
I'm the champion!
Defeat, retreat, those are not in my words. I don't understand those definitions. I don't understand when things go wrong. I don't understand mistakes. But I do understand this. I understand victory, and I understand never surrendering. No matter how bad things go, my heart, my mind will carry my body when my limbs are too weak.
Who am I? I'm the champion!
Today will be that day. Not tomorrow, not next week, but right now, right here, in your house and in your home. Who am I?
I'm the champion!
History will remember me! I will not let anybody hit me behind. I will define myself! I will write my own praises! And no one will tell me what I can never be! I will never go out, not knowing I've given everything I've got! Cause who am I?
I'm the champion!
Who am I?